anyone, really.
Right.
And I'm just like,
you've never really, exactly, like, you've never actually told us anything about that, like that.
No.
You know? And, yeah, I just want to, like, reiterate that we have never once said that you guys were coming after anybody. We never said that we were going after you guys. Obviously, we know that people are painting this flip on us, but and we were the ones that were against it. Mm-hmm. And
regardless of the flip, like, because it's gonna be so hard to figure out.
I know,
but I like, where are the rumors coming from about me and Ro?
What are the rumors? Which ones?
I'm coming after all the girls. There's one more about me. That might have been the big one. I'm coming after all the girls, and Ro's coming after Tina and Tara. What's the other one?
Ro's coming after Tina and Tara.
That was, like, coursing through the house.
Well, obviously you know who's scared of you on, if we're in a team setting, right? Like, on my team.
I don't really. Yeah, okay. So right? There's one female.
Obviously.
But it's confusing. Yeah, like, it's...
So, yeah. So it's like, that would make sense for her game, mm-hmm. you know, to kind of paint that picture, mm-hmm. because she's, what, like, obviously was scared, mm-hmm. if you were to win or whatever, mm-hmm. that she would be the option to go up. Mm-hmm. So in that sense, seeing Ro as like a, as your, one of your closest allies, mm-hmm. would have been ideal in a flip situation, you know? It wouldn't have been ideal for Ty and I. Uh-huh. So that's why I just want to, like, kind of reiterate the fact that, Ro, I'm just kind of trying to emphasize the fact that Ty and I had no part in this flip.
Yeah.
And, like I came and talked to you mid-chaos.
Yeah.
And made sure everything was straight because right. I was like, I don't want you to go home.
Yeah.
And we never orchestrated anything. We were the ones that were shutting it down. It was the other people, i.e. the females, that were scared of you guys.
Yeah.
And... like, I'm just, like, pretty upset with people like Tara because she was one of the main people that wanted it to happen.
Right.
And now she's, like, you know, like, pretending like she didn't.
Right.
And she comes to the couch and says, oh, like, I'm voting Josh for sure, blah, blah, blah. But right before that, she was trying to get us to vote for you.
Right.
So it's just, like, very wishy-washy. And now we're being painted as the people that, like, orchestrated it and been saying you guys' names when we never did and we never wanted to.
Like, so, one question I have is, even when Tara was clearly going to vote for me to stay at mm-hmm. that point, like, close to the end, mm-hmm. like, were you guys not still trying to rally 5-6 votes to bring it over the line at that point?
We were not trying to rally votes.
But would you have went with it?
Who's rallying votes? Because obviously there was a meeting at the top of the stairs to still rally votes, and if it was going to be there, then it was going to happen.
That's what we know.
Yeah. At that point, Tina and Tara were not voting to evict me. They were voting to evict Josh. So there's still an attempt to get 6 votes over the line.
There was no possibility of getting 6 votes because we were not going to vote that way. Like, people
were... in who? You and Ty?
Me and Ty, yeah. Like, we had no intention of voting for you to go.
Right.
In this game, obviously, you need to hear out both sides, pros mm-hmm. and cons.
Yeah.
So we were listening.
Yeah.
But... we literally went to bed the night before and said, unanimous vote Josh. We woke up in the morning, unanimous vote Josh.
Yeah.
30 minutes before the fucking vote, we start hearing, it's a flip.
Yeah.
And then we're like, what? And then I'm just saying, people, like, obviously, you know, LaToya had a part, Tara. Mm-hmm. Those people are the ones that were pushing for it hard.
Yeah.
Josh campaigned super hard before he left.
Yeah.
Promising people things like Tara. People that were on the outside, people that are super paranoid about this week.
Yeah.
And they bought into it. And Tara talked to me multiple times the day before the eviction saying, we need to do this. Because if Josh stays and it's still teams, I can put him up and I don't have any blood on my hands. If Rose stays and I have to put him up, that's a lot more blood on my hands.
Yeah.
That doesn't help my game at all. I was never going to put you up anyways. I'm never going to put Kyle up anyways. Told him that to his face.
Yeah.
So you staying is better for me instead of Josh, who said that he's personally coming after me.
Right. Well, me staying is better for you, and I told you that in the HOH room and in the pantry too, right? Like, it's not in your best, even right now, like, it's not even in your best interest to take me out of the game, and I wouldn't take you out of the game, right? I
completely agree.
And that was, like, a completely 100% conversation that we had twice.
Right.
And that's what I tried to reiterate in Expedia yesterday when I came in to see what was going on.
Right.
I'm never going to blame anybody for looking at both sides. There's two people on the block at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. One person's got to go. Even if it seems like it's unanimous the whole week, it might not be. And if there's an opportunity to better your own game from someone's perspective, then you got to take that opportunity and at least discuss the option. So I'm not like, yeah. I'm never upset at that. Like, I knew it was a possibility going on the block, but mm-hmm. I guess like, yeah, when we were talking to Ty yesterday, it was just like, well, give us a name. Like, if it's not like, because people are telling us this is not coming like from us, right? Like, right. This is just me asking questions because I'm on the block and I don't want to go home. But like, people are coming up to us and being like, okay, like Ty and Jed, like, you know, this is the situation.
And the rumors.
Conversations are happening right now. So like, us. Naturally, like, we've got to be like, okay, like, what the fuck's going on?
Right.
So like, we just like need a name of like, so like you said, Tara and LaToya, for example, of like, who's like orchestrating this chaos.
Right.
But like, at the end of the day, Tara was not going to vote to evict me, like right when the eviction was happening. And I know even after that point, there was still an attempt to make the flip. So I'm just wondering, like, who at that point, obviously if it wasn't you, if it wasn't Ty, like, who at that point was making the push to still make the flip happen, even without Tara and Tina voting to evict me?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious.
So it's LaToya.
I mean, yeah. Like, I mean.
But there has to be four other people, doesn't there?
Yeah, like, but there was no, that's why it didn't happen, because there was no votes.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like Ty and I, we're not down for it.
Right.
You know, we weren't down for it. We were the ones doing damage control to stop it.
Yeah.
Up until 30 minutes before the eviction.
Yeah.
We had said this is a unanimous vote. It's easy.
Right.
We don't need Josh to stay for any protection. We're pretty secure right now with you guys.
Yeah.
So like, we're not worried about you guys coming after us. Whereas other people in this game are terrified of you guys going after them. So they wanted Josh to stay as a target.
So that's the other thing. Like, who came up with this? Because I found out like 6-7 things about me yesterday that I didn't even fucking know.
Right. Me too.
So it was just
6-7 things.
Yeah, yeah. Just like random shit. Like Rose going after the girls. Rose going after Tina and Taylor. Or like, who's coming up with this shit?
I honestly think it's like an assumption. Just like the assumption that Kyle's.
Well, like it was a, but it was a very well-known rumor around. It wasn't an assumption because everybody else is talking about it except Kyle and I.
Yeah.
At that point, it's just like Ro and Kyle are going after the girls. So like. People had to be talking about it. It wasn't just an assumption. So someone had to come up with it and start spreading it around. And who was that person?
That's the question I have.
Too. And like things I'm saying to you guys, like I'm hearing back from other people, and it's like completely twisted. And I'm just like, no, it didn't happen like that.
Like what?
So like, we haven't. The only times we've ever like discussed your guys' names, it's been because we were told that. You guys were like, Ro was gone this week, and I was next, essentially. Like, if you had the votes, Ro was gone, and then I was the target. So obviously, reaction. We have an hour to save Ro. We're like, fuck, like, no.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? Because it's like we're just hearing things that are completely pulled from the clouds.
It's just like, I think it was just people that really wanted you to go, and then it didn't happen,
mm-hmm.
and then they just started shitstorming and completely deflected on Ty and I,
mm-hmm.
and they try to make us implode. Mm-hmm. Whereas we never wanted you to go.
Yeah.
And, like, we almost now are being punished for a move that wasn't even ours.
Yeah.
And the people that orchestrated it.
Yeah.
Obviously starting with Josh because he was doing the campaigning. And then mainly the girls that are scared of you guys.
Yeah.
They're the ones that just fell back into the shadows once it didn't go through and pushed it right onto us.
So it was a girl that was saying we were going after the girls?
Because yes.
It had to be someone.
Well, yeah. Okay. Like, why would we say that? We're not the girls. So we don't care.
Well, yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah, like.
So it has to be girls. So really, at the end of the day, it has to be Tara, Beth, or LaToya that said it.
It has to be.
So it has to be one of those three people that created that?
It has to be, yeah, because it's one of the girls.
Okay.
So it's like, it wasn't us. We knew that you guys aren't coming for us.
And we still, like, we, even though we feel a little bit, like, kind of betrayed in a sense, like, because I thought the whole time it was going to be, obviously you're going to consider it, right? But I didn't consider it to get as crazy as it did. And then to hear all the girl stuff, we're like, what the hell is going on? Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, but, I mean, Ty can say, like, we didn't push for that. We really didn't.
The way it was brought.
Because it's just not true. But it's frustrating. It's okay when things have a little merit and, like, you can be like, okay, fuck, like. But, like, when things are completely made up, it's frustrating to hear.
Well, the thing is, it's just, like, it just wouldn't be in your best interest. Because, like, if I go to this game and then Kyle goes out of the game next, then, like, you guys are massive targets.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, there's just, like, if anybody else wins HOH except for the two of you, like, there's a great chance that you two go on the block.
Absolutely.
And we always said from the jump, we would watch out for each other. We said that from time.
And even after all this, like, where we, like, are getting told that you guys are saying a lot of shit about us, we still haven't gone to Vic and pushed for you guys.
And,
you know what I mean?
So vice versa, yeah.
Like, we haven't gone to Vic once and been, like, put Ty in jail.
No, we talked to Vic as well. And we said, don't put, we literally said the same thing. Even though we didn't really know where we stood yesterday, we never once put you guys in her head. It was everyone except for you.
She even asked.
She asked. She said, what do you think about Kyle?
What do you guys think about Kyle? Did they say anything bad about me? No.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
So did she ask you, like, for names or anything? Like, did you guys give recommendations?
Well, I personally said Tara because Tara said my name multiple times.
Right.
She put me up first in the HOH challenge in an attempt to get me out.
Right.
So she has done things to me that I feel like I can say her name without any major, like, backlash.
Right.
So I did say Tara.
Yeah.
I didn't really pitch names. The thing is, she pitched names. Yeah. The names she pitched,
yeah,
honestly, makes sense.
Which ones did she pitch?
She pitched
Kiefer because he, like, Kiefer lied to her face.
And
Latoya. Kiefer and Toya.
Yeah.
Kiefer. What a bad move.
Kiefer.
No, Kiefer fucked up hard.
Kiefer just bit off a little more than he could chew.
Yeah.
But,
you know what I mean? Up. And she feels like those two people are responsible for what happened yesterday. And to a degree, there's some, I can't argue with that.
So if Latoya's on the block, you guys are okay with that based on what happened with the flip? Because obviously if Tara wasn't going to vote to evict me, then Latoya would have been one to continue to push it, right?
Yeah.
If that's what I'm observing.
At the end of the day, like, if that's what it takes to show that we didn't orchestrate this at all, then it is what it is. Like,
well, I genuinely don't think that you guys orchestrated it.
I genuinely don't either.
I don't. Like, I came into the room Expedia yesterday, I saw your face, I was like, Jed didn't orchestrate this, for sure.
The one thing that we just can't understand is the rumors. We just
don't understand, like, where they're getting created
and, like, why they're getting spread. Like, obviously you guys had to spread them though. Like, when you hear them.
Yeah, I mean, like, people are talking about them, but who created them, we're narrowing it down to three people essentially then, right?
Yeah. Like, obviously you hear things and then all of a sudden it's like people that you're close with are included in those rumors.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, oh, okay, like, we hear the same rumors. We hear, okay, Kyle and Ro want a gun for Latoya or something like that.
Like, we've had a good relationship. That never came out of my mouth.
Yeah, exactly, I know. Never. But, like,
I genuinely thought I had a good relationship with Latoya, which is why this is so weird to me.
Yeah.
Because, like, I've had, like, transparent, like, conversations with her about everything.
Right.
So I was just like, what?
Well, I think even she, that's why I think she was surprised as well. She
won't even look at me.
Oh, yeah, I don't know. I think, well, like,
I'm just like, hey, how's it going? Like, nothing. Don't even respond to me.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm just
I don't know.
I literally did not do anything to her. Yeah.
So does she just come up, like, does she just make the scenarios in her head? Like, I don't know.
I think it's just like a, like, you know, I think she's the type of person that just kind of reads people. And I think she just thinks that you don't like her for a fact. And then you're just, like, associated with him, so you don't like her as well, or something like that.
That's what I would assume. Bullshit, though.
And the reality is, too, if we're really thinking about last week, everybody was going through scenarios on who would be put up, depending on who won each other.
Yeah.
And I think with teams and the assumption, they figured that she must have figured that you would come for her. I don't know what else, like...
Well, our team was so
sparse. Well, Latoya, you have a sparse team, and you haven't talked game with me.
Right.
That's the only thing, like...
But don't go around and make up rumors about me. Right. Otherwise, it's going to happen the other... Like, you know what I mean?
Because, like, look, I mean, quite frankly, she did it, and she's put herself in a really negative position right now, and she's in jeopardy of going on the block.
Right.
Like, that's the fact of the matter, if that's what Vic told you guys, right? So
yeah. And, like, we completely understand that, and although we do have a good relationship with her, at the end of the day, like, it was a pretty bad move.
Yeah.
And we don't want to be associated with that move just because we have a good relationship.
Right.
So if that means that she has to go on the block before us, then that's fine. Like, at the end of the day, it's an individual game.
Mm-hmm.
So we're not going to, like stress over that because mm-hmm. it was a move that she made and we don't agree with that move.
Right.
And we were kind of roped into that.
So if it were, what did you say, Kiefer and Toya?
Yeah.
So if it were those two on the block and, like, one of you guys won veto, would you just leave it the same?
Well, we would have to talk to Vic.
That would be a good question.
True.
We would have to talk
like whatever
to Vic.
Vic wants. Yeah.
Because Vic said, like, look, talk to me tomorrow about the veto.
Right.
And she's like, Kiefer's my target, blah, blah, blah. I want him to go.
Yeah.
And Toya's a
pawn. I think Kiefer is her target, to be honest. Yeah.
So, like, if that's true, then... It may be unnecessary to use it.
Right.
But that she would have to, like, kind of stay true to that.
True.
So
that's unknown at this point because she feels like Latoya is on the block because she could flip a vote.
yeah.
in general.
Right, right, right. You know what I'm like, not necessarily because she wants to get Toya out.
Exactly.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. She's scared that if Toya isn't on the block, she'll be able to flip votes and be a vote towards not getting Kiefer out.
True.
So she wants Kiefer out so bad that she'll put the person that she thinks is like the mastermind behind flipping votes on the block.
That makes sense.
Right?
She feels like both weeks, the flip is orchestrated by Toya.
I mean, that's kind of true. I mean, like,
clear
Toya really did start the Julie thing. Like, she wanted Julie out from the get. Well, I mean, like, Toya really just wanted Julie out from the get go.
Right.
So it's like, for us to be like, it's not even. That's why I was shocked you guys even believe them.
Believe what?
We would orchestrate a flip, or we would come for you guys.
I don't think we believe that you orchestrated the flip.
Yeah, we don't think. We genuinely don't think that you guys orchestrated it.
So what did you? Like, what was it?
Well, I was just asking questions because it was like 3 hours before the eviction, and I'm like, I'm on a fucking block. Like, I could go home if I don't like figure out what's going on. So people come up to me and tell me like, oh, Jed and Ty, blah blah blah. So I've just asked questions. Like, I got LaToya pulling people into rooms. Like, I have no clue what the fuck's going on. To me, it's just chaos. So,
Are you able to tell us who said that it was us orchestrating it?
Well, just like people coming in and out of rooms. it was like more than one person. Like, you can probably just like handpick somebody in the house. And they probably said it. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So,
I mean, I guess it, like at the end of the day, it looked bad because we were in those rooms, but we weren't in those rooms pushing for you to go.
True, yeah.
That's all I can say about that. Yeah. It's like, we didn't want you to go. We knew it was terrible for our game if you went.
Yeah.
There are people that would have benefited from you going, and those are the ones that wanted you to go.
Yeah.
And they just didn't have the votes because we would not give our votes.
Who do you guys put up then if you win that HOH?
Yesterday?
Yeah.
I'm putting up, who am I putting up? I'm definitely putting up Tara. And who else am I putting up? I may have to put up Kiefer as well because he's just stepped on a lot of toes. Mm-hmm. And I think that would be the least blood.
Mm-hmm. Same with you?
I think, would you do the same, Ty? Mm-hmm. Something similar? Yeah.
And you'd want Tara out in that scenario?
Yes, in that scenario, yeah.
Tara, I don't know. I get this vibe she's coming for Jed.
Coming for Jed?
It just seems that way.
Oh, true. There's
something fishy about Tara's game. She flips and flops.
Yeah.
She's
kind of a loose cannon.
She worries me a little bit.
Like, do you guys trust her?
Not fully, no. She's just like, she just kind of says what's on her mind. She doesn't really, like, think through.
Like, I have nothing, no ill will against her, but it just pained me to see how hard she was pushing for you to go, and then 5 seconds later, she's sitting on the couch with you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that pisses me off.
It's just like...
Who do you guys put up?
She's probably one. If like what you're saying is like she's the one that pushes the flip, then I probably do her and Toya, to be honest.
Her and Toya?
Yeah. But I mean, just based on what happened yesterday.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
No, it makes complete sense.
Yeah. I mean, Toya, and then I'd kind of have to think about the other one.
Yeah.
Because like it's hard to say because like if you're not HOH, you don't have the genuine conversations where people are being like completely transparent of like what really, like, you know?
Exactly. Like, people start telling the truth more when they're in the back sense of all, for sure.
Now that you have names for yesterday.
Because I mean, when I get out on that HOH competition, all I hear is Toya cheering. When I'm out.
That was true. She was cheering.
Oh, you were right there. Yeah. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
I honestly didn't even know.
Yeah. No, you were probably just paying attention. Yeah. But like I was already out, like I was on the bench.
Oh,
I was already
out. Not a noise.
Like, oh,
yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
she was like
yes,
yes. She was like
oh really?
Yeah.
Wow, I didn't even see that either.
So I mean
what do you mean I don't like you? You wouldn't see me do that if you got out, you know what I mean?
Right.
Well, question. We gave you names for yesterday, too.
The thing is about that, too, is, like, you didn't give us Toya until we gave you Toya. So it's like, you know what I mean? Until we told you that we knew it was Toya. And then you told Toya.
Well, I don't think our automatic reaction is to throw someone on the bus we have good relationships with.
I know, but if that's who actually did it.
For sure, but, like, at the end of the day, right, it's either falls on you or it falls on that person.
Exactly. So... Like, once we realized you guys are, like, really believing that it was us, and, like, you got to think about the game. Like, obviously, it's you before I, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
When it comes to that, so it's just, like, yeah, like, we'll give you...
Well, if you're telling me, like, it was Tara originally, like, I can believe that. But
it was Tara originally.
Yeah, for sure.
But you asked me who was in the rooms pushing.
Yeah, yeah. Like, last minute, like, when Tara was for sure voting for me to stay, right? Like, who was that person? So, obviously, it was Toya in that scenario.
Right, 100%.
Okay.
But I don't want you to be blind to the fact that Tara was a huge part of it.
Right.
And now she's kind of flipping again. So
if we go talk to Vic, like, you think it would make most sense for us to push to get Tara on the block?
I mean, I'm not going to tell you guys what to do, but if I'm HOH, she's on the block.
Okay.
I mean, I don't want to, I know Vic doesn't like to be told what to do for her HOH, so like, I don't want to tell her what to do.
Yeah.
We just told her who we think, and we just told her what the repercussions of each side would be. And if that means Tara, like, even as like a potential replacement, or if like even right on the block, but I just know that she doesn't want Toya to be in the voting pool. So I think that her nominees are pretty locked in at this point. And then it would just come down to the veto and what she wants us to do with it.
Do you think I should pull Tara aside and just call her out one-on-one? Without mentioning your name?
I mean, you could. Like, at this point, like, I think that our bridge is burnt.
Yeah.
Just because I know that she's been talking about me, and, like, I've obviously been talking about her.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I wouldn't really care, but I wouldn't be surprised if she just, like, lied to your face.
Right. So maybe I'll pull her aside one-on-one, and I'll just, like, call her out for the flip, and I won't mention your name,
obviously. Well, you can ask her. Say, were you... Just, like, ask her, like, were you pushing for the flip?
Yeah.
Because she came to me three times the day before and said, this is a good move.
Right.
And then right when it was time for her to pull the trigger, she didn't do it. So,
right.
And then just blamed it on us.
At the end of the day, he's still here.
Yeah.
But, like, hopefully there's no more rumors going around about us. I'm not accusing you guys of doing it.
Yeah.
But, like...
Like, we didn't do it.
But if you guys hear something about us, like, come and tell us. Because we just found out fucking yesterday.
Well, we were
things
in a weird
that we don't
place,
know about ourselves.
You know?
Huh?
Like, we were in a weird place where we didn't know where you guys were at. We didn't know if this was a fucking battle now. Like, we didn't know what we were doing.
Well, just because I thought the boat was flipping. That's why I was just like, well, like, what the fuck's going on?
So did we, though.
Yeah.
That's the thing. I'm hearing we have the numbers. We're flipping the house. I'm like, how? This doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
And then, like, Kiefer coming to tell us, like, you know, those guys said they're coming after you next week.
And I'm hearing that.
And then we're
week.
Like... We're like, what the fuck? Like, so now,
do we know that?
Does that
mean,
No, we don't know that.
Yeah, well, yeah, and then it's like, does that mean that we're keeping somebody that is coming for our heads next week? Like, what? Like, now we're confused.
Kiefer just got trying.
Kiefer's fucking got all over
trying
the place
to play too. Everyone.
I didn't know that he said that.
Yeah, I told you guys that yesterday.
Did you?
Right
oh, fuck.
Kitchen.
I was, man,
I was like, that's why, because we heard you guys were coming after us. That's why we were, like, in the rooms, like, what the fuck?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we used to know it was coming from Kiefer.
Yeah.
Nah, Kiefer likes to...
Yeah,
Kiefer, he tried to play...
I think he was just floating
everyone.
And then got kind of caught in
both
sides.
He tried to just play both sides aggressively. Right. And just, like, bit off more than he could chew. Right. And it's just, like, completely blatantly obvious.
Yeah, as soon as he pulled me aside and tried to throw Vic under the bus, I was just like, I could see in his eyes, you're lying to me.
Well, when I came up, he says this, and I come out, and Kyle's not looking at me.
Yeah.
I was just cheesed on the couch like this. I was just like,
I just try to take everything in before I made like call them out and being a liar.
Right.
I was trying to like, I just had to make sure.
When he said that, then you wouldn't look at me in my face. I'm like, oh my god, is he telling the truth? Really,
that's what I thought.
I was really coming from you.
I don't know. At the end of the day, like, I know we're gonna battle eventually, but like, I don't want it to be this soon.
Yeah.
You know what
I
mean?
No, neither do we. That's
and, like,
why
we don't
I
want
like...
it to be so fucking awkward.
Like, no,
oh,
for sure.
Fuck. Yeah. No matter what happens, it shouldn't be awkward.
Yeah,
I don't think it's in either of our best interests to take each other out because immediately then the others become targets.
Exactly.
I mean, obviously, like, we're the four biggest targets in the house.
Absolutely.
Just, like, based on everything that's happened in 2 weeks.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
And, like, we haven't, like, twisted anything you guys have said to people. We just hope that can be, like, mutually... You know?
Yeah, reciprocated for
there's
sure.
No, yeah, like there's no scenario in which I have ever said Kyle said, or Kyle this, or I think Kyle.
Yeah.
No,
like Vic blatantly asked us yesterday, has Kyle Rowe ever talked shit about me? And I was like, no. Like, I couldn't even if I wanted to rat you guys out, you haven't said anything.
Right,
you
know? Yeah.
So,
yeah, barely a doctor.
There's no reason.
That's what we were saying. That's why, like, the rumors were like, what the hell, man? Like, we haven't really said anything.
You guys don't really talk shit about people. Like,
no. I need to do me.
Yeah, like,
I'm just on vacation.
Seriously.
Have you heard me talk shit about anybody?
Nah.
No.
Nice guy, Ty.
Ty's balling.
And Vic would never be like, oh, Ty and Jed said this about Kyle and Bro, because that would just never happen.
Yeah, for sure. No, I believe you.
I think we have just like a underlying understanding that we want to move forward as a kind of a crew, even though we have established like a crazy alliance, like we from day one,
yeah,
day two with us, we talked and said We're not gunning for each other.
Right.
Early, because once two of us are out,
yeah,
the other two are full on target.
Massive
by everyone
targets,
else.
Yeah.
So we need to like just stick together.
Yeah.
Like we can do our things and like whatever play with the relationships we have. But
yeah,
I feel like there are bigger fish to fry in this game.
Yeah.
That aren't us.
Yeah.
And it's in our best interest to get them out first.
Yeah.
And then when it comes down to the line, we want to battle it out. Like, that's fine. We're fine with that.
Yeah.
But, like, right now, I just don't want to be gunning after each other like this.
That's what I mean, because I feel like the tension between us is about taking heat off other people.
Yeah, people are skating by now.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, the terrors of this world skate to Jury.
Yeah.
The keys of this world skate by.
Right.
And they're lying. You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah, no, I know exactly what you're saying.
There's too many people being able to skate by.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this is literally what Josh wanted. he wanted to create the alliance, the Pretty Boy Alliance, and then if it didn't work, he wanted to pin them against each other. And like,
I don't
want that
to happen.
I don't want that to happen. So I just want to reiterate to you guys, like, didn't want you out, didn't start any rumors about you, didn't spread them, and we want you guys in this game for as long as possible.
Yeah.
And we think that there are other people that need to go.
Yeah.
Way before you.
Okay.
And I hope you guys feel the same.
We do, for sure.
And we don't have to, I don't have to be calling you Rohan instead of the show. But yeah.
All right. Well, yeah, thanks for pulling us aside. It's better just to clear it up.
Yeah, yeah. I don't like this weird animosity.
No.
I couldn't even sleep last night. I was so stressed.
I didn't sleep very good either.
I was like,
what's
the room going to be?
I might have heard a kiss last night, Ty.
Oh, stop.
Huh?
Oh.
What's that?
I said I heard a kiss last night, Ty.
Oh, you guys kissed?
Ty doesn't kiss.
Oh.
Jeez.
Oh. Did he tell you yet? Did he tell you yet?
What, last night?
Yeah.
Tell you what?
I heard a...
No, you did not.
Shut up. I thought you don't lie.
Bro.
You're lying.
You heard a kiss?
Yeah.
Blue line.
I probably did this.
Oh, yeah. I sucked my lips.
Kiss.
Yeah.
That's jokes.
I'm a gangster. We don't kiss, bro.
Yeah, all right, buddy.
But I like the pony.
Oh, my God.
Did you guys really not kiss last night?
We don't kiss, bro. We just cuddle.
Yes, you do kiss, you idiot.
Oh.
He told me you did.
Oh, I thought you don't lie.
A couple days ago.
Nah. Messing with you.
Right after I kissed her, she told me you kissed her.
Nope. That's why I go around.
He's like, fuck, I gotta get in there.
I literally said that.
Get your fucking story straight.
Bro.
We'll give you 2 seconds.
Nah.
Get your story straight, boy.
Listen. It's a move on her part.
Oh, okay.
She's like, Jed, come for me. Ty kissed me.
This love triangle's heating up, bro.
It's a move.
I'm done. You better not let any love get in the way of the boys.
Who, me?
You better not point at them.
Oh, shut up.
No, I'm kidding.
Sam and Adam.
This is literally the exact same situation.
Yeah.
Sam and Adam?
We got the PB, and then you're going to be pulled away by
me?
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here. You guys know I said from the jump, I'm not with any of that shit.
I'm sick.
Fuck, it's nice out.
I'm going to stay out here as long as possible, honestly.
Are you fucking with me?
Did I hear a kiss? No.
Bro, why are you lying?
But what?
Why are you lying?
But what? Kissing her?
Yeah.
Bro, we did not kiss.
Why are you lying?
You guys don't believe me?
No, I actually don't.
You're capping, bro. You're
capping. I heard it.
When?
I heard the whispering for like an hour.
Oh,
and then.
Shit.
When? Like before we got up?
Yeah. Before you got up to bang in the shower?
You guys are ridiculous.
You get up every night and you go make out on the couch. I already knew that.
What?
What?
Really?
Really?
I don't know. I just assume. I know you guys get up every night, though.
We don't get up every night. We got up last night because we couldn't sleep. We just kissed.
Couldn't sleep because of the tension.